All right, we're doing Four on the Floor right now, brought to you by Citywide Banks. Four questions, 30 seconds each. When the bell goes off, stop talking. Jim McElwain and the Florida Gators are 4-0. Does it end this week when they play Ole Miss at home?
Yes, because here's what they don't have, and McElwain doesn't have: a good enough offense against Ole Miss's defense. And Ole Miss has the best receiver in the league in Treadwell. And they've got a pretty damn good quarterback. But they've got a defense. If you don't follow Ole Miss, they got a defense just like the Broncos defense that will hurt you. If you're going to come over the middle, we're going to hurt you.
Yeah.
We're going to hurt you sometimes after the play's dead. We're going to hurt you. See, and I shouldn't say this. Maybe I should write a column about this Sunday. I like that they're getting those. I like the Oakland Raiders. The teams then get afraid of you. You know when the Broncos were successful? I'm sorry. When the Broncos were successful was when they were crackback blocking everybody.
Oh, yeah.
You could get away with that.
They were seen as a dirty team.
Everybody. Chad Brown will tell you, they were afraid of the Broncos.
There were complaints every week from the opposition.
I kind of like that fear.
I think the Florida magic is going to continue at home for Jim McElwain. They're doing it with smoke and mirrors. And the smoke and mirrors are going to come through again.
They haven't played anybody.
Florida's not that good. They're not that good.
They're Jag?
They're just another team. They're Jat. Yeah, they're just another team. But they're at the swamp. That's going to be the difference.
In Jat, what you have to play when you leave a country? You got to pay those taxes, those Jat taxes.
Should Larry Brown be allowed to come back and coach Southern Methodist after his suspension ends? I'm going first on this. All right? No. Absolutely. I think it's over for Larry. This is the third school he's done this at. UCLA and Kansas also found in violation, recruiting violations. He's gotten three Division I schools in trouble now. He's 75. It's going to hurt recruiting at SMU. I don't know Larry as well as you do. I know him a little bit. I'd love to see him continue and continue cleanly, but I think it's over for Larry now.
Oh, did John Calipari get two schools in the...
He did.
Yeah, oh, gosh, he's still coaching, isn't he? Jim Boeheim, is he still coaching in Syracuse?
He's suspended, last time actually.
Yeah, he got suspended, but he didn't get fired. You know, he had assistant coach that had issues.
Boeheim should have left 10 years ago, too,
okay,
in my opinion.
I mean, you look around and suddenly Larry Brown's different from everybody else. Bob Knight once told me, he said, you'd be amazed at the guys you have respect for. He was just me and him.
Yeah.
He said, you'd be amazed at the guy you have respect for, you think are the greatest, cleanest coaches in the world.
Nope.
They're not. He said, I am. Yes, Larry, I will say this. Larry should be able to come back. He did something really good for the ASUM program. They cheated with one guy. But I listened to Larry yesterday. I looked at the stuff. He should retire. He shouldn't be fired. He should retire.
Yeah.
He is...
with a little bit of dignity.
He just is not Larry Brown that I was around for a long, long time.
All right. Brandon Whedon or Matt Cassel, who you got?
I want to take my 30 seconds here to say that Matt Cassel could have ended up as a Broncos quarterback. Do you know that?
Yeah.
If you liked Cowboy,
that would have been ugly.
Love... Well, that's who Josh McDaniels was trying to get.
Yeah, I know.
No. So Whedon in a poll I saw, and I don't think it's question day, a poll I saw, but guy we've had on the show from CBS Sports, Pat Kerwin, right? Picked Whedon as the best backup quarterback in the league. Are we discussing this later?
We were, but we're running out of time.
Okay. Do you know who he had as 31?
Yeah,
next
Brock
to last?
Osweiler.
Brock Osweiler.
That was ridiculous.
How do we know? That's his whole point. We don't know whether he could play.
Well... look at Matt Cassel. We know. He's been on 5 teams in 8 years. He's been given every opportunity in the world. And he got it done 1 year for New England when there was this incredible support system around him when Tom Brady was out for that whole year. Whedon completed 89% of his passes last week. He was 29 for 33 for over 300 yards.
Do you know how many?
He's got to get another chance.
Do you know how many consecutive starts he's lost?
Yeah, I know.
How many? You didn't use this in
9?
Nine? The guy has lost 9 consecutive games as a starter, and you want him over anybody? But Matt Cassel, the only thing I'll say about Matt Cassel is from the time he was in high school till now, he started like 7 games. He was a backup the whole time he was in college.
And there's a good reason for that. Yeah. He's been given every opportunity. He hasn't made good.
They should have signed Tebow.
Here you go. Astros, Angels, or Twins? Who you got?
I like the Angels manager best of all. Mike Socha's been there. He knows what it is. He's a great manager in my mind. I think that, and the Angels have been there. They got some veterans. They got a guy that's a catcher from around here. They got guys that have been around a long time. They got one reason they're going to win. Two words. Mike Trout.
I'm going to go Houston. I'm going to say, all right, let me put it this way.
I say the Twins, Trout, he says Fish.
Forget about the Twins, all right? They're not in this conversation.
Carpy.
Not from a lineup standpoint, they're not ready, and not from a pitching standpoint, they're not good enough. Houston has pretty good top three in the rotation between Keuchel and McCullers and who's their third?
Who knows?
Nah, they got a pretty good third pitcher. Kazmir, all right? That's pretty good, but their lineup isn't quite good enough. So I'm changing my mind. I'm going with the Angels. Mike, you know, baseball is a sport where one guy can't usually carry a team. Mike Trout can carry a team. Plus, they've got the experience in Socha. They've got Pujols in the middle of that lineup too. They've got C.J. Wilson at the top of the rotation. From top to bottom, it's a decent rotation. Yeah. So I think I'm with you on that. Angels with Houston a close second.
Hello.
Yeah.
What? You just changed your mind?
I did, yeah.
You were telling me? Okay. All right, because here's the other point you should know. And Jimmy, get the clip. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I like Kazmir in my coats, not on my mound.